ADC's all-new e-sphyg 3 is a feature-packed, professional-grade NIBP monitor with three clinically validated modes, including single measurement mode, customizable average mode, and manual mode. In this video, we'll show you how to take a manual reading using a stethoscope. In this mode, the e-sphyg 3 device serves only as a pressure gauge. You'll need to use a stethoscope to listen for systolic and diastolic carotid cough sounds. If the device is off, press the power button on the back of the unit. If you wish to change the maximum inflation pressure, you can do so now. Press and hold the memory button for 3 seconds until the current value begins flashing. Press the start-stop button to change the value, then press the memory button again to confirm the selected value. If needed, slide the mode switch to select manual mode. Place the cuff around the patient's arm. The cuff index line should fall within the printed range markers. If not, select a larger or smaller cuff to ensure an accurate reading. The artery mark should be positioned over the brachial artery. The bottom edge of the cuff should be about 1 inch above the antecubital fold. Make sure the arm is relaxed and supported, and ask the patient to stay still and quiet. With the cuff in place, press the stop-start button. The cuff will begin inflating. While the cuff is inflating, position the stethoscope over the brachial artery, distal to the antecubital fold. When the cuff reaches maximum pressure, deflation will begin automatically, and you can begin auscultation. Take note of the systolic and diastolic values as if you were measuring with a sphygmomanometer. When the cuff deflates to 20 millimeters of mercury, the remaining pressure will vent automatically and the unit will enter standby mode. You can push the start-stop button at any time during deflation to vent and enter standby mode.